Hello friends, hope you are all doing fantastic. Today in this video I am going to explain the Duckworth-Lewis-Stern method and the underlying math behind it. I am Vinay, and you are watching Cricktech Digital. Let's start.
Oh, that's smashed square of the wicket.
The method is used in limited overs cricket match interrupted by weather or other circumstances. It was devised by two English statisticians, Frank Duckworth and Tony Lewis. It was introduced in 1997 and adopted officially by the ICC in 1999. After the retirements of Duckworth and Lewis, Professor Stephen Stern became the custodian of the method, and it was renamed to its current title in November 2014. The essence of the DL method is resources. Each team is considered to have two resources to use to score as many runs as possible, the number of overs left, and the number of wickets they have in hand. The method considers the additional runs scored by a team is proportional to the resources left. Let's go through the math. Here, S refers to the runs scored, and V refers to the overs left. In this method, the scoring rate that is DS by DV is considered proportional to 1, a function of number of wickets in hand, Y, and 2 inversely proportional to exponential of overs left, V, with a negative sign. The negative sign indicates positive scoring rate for decreasing overs left. From the graph, we can see that scoring rate is higher when we have less overs left. The combined differential equation comes out to be DS by DV is equal to negative Y times exponential of minus BV. Note that Y and B both here are only functions of wickets left. Upon integration, we get S with limits from final score S to initial score 0 is equal to Y by B times exponential of minus BV, with limits from 0 overs left to initial of V overs left. Y by B is combined into one constant Z, which is a function of wickets in hand. After applying limits, we get S is equal to Z times 1 minus exponential of negative BV. The maximum scoring rate is obtained when V is minimum, or there is one ball left, which is close to Z times B. Note that Z here is the asymptotic run scored with infinite overs left. Hence we have 10 different equations for different number of wickets in hand, varying from Z10 to Z1. These constant Z1 to Z10 and B1 to B10 are obtained from regression of data from actual matches played. Z and B are revised once in every year, and the regression gives more weightage to the recent matches played. This is how these 10 equations look. On y-axis, we have the estimated runs that can be scored from remaining overs on the x-axis. Since runs scored is proportional to resources left, this graph can also be seen as estimated resources in percentage left from remaining overs on the x-axis. From this graph, for example, we can say a team has 50% resources left after losing 3 wickets at the end of 30 overs. In other words, a team having scored 150 runs with 7 wickets in hand with 20 overs left is estimated to score 300 runs at the end of the innings. The same equation is converted by a computer into a table of this sort for easier understanding of par score. In second innings, Team 2 must score one extra run than determined from DLS method to win. To understand better, let's take a real match example. In 2003, Sri Lanka played South Africa in World Cup Pool B. Sri Lanka batted first and scored 268 for 9 from their 50 overs. Chasing a target of 269, South Africa had reached 229 for 6 from 45 overs when play was abandoned. From the table, we get with 5 overs left and 4 wickets in hand, you have 14.3% resources left. That means you have utilized 85.7% of resources to get to 229 runs. DLS par score is 85.7% of 268 runs, which is 229.7 runs. Therefore, South Africa's retrospective target from their 45 overs was 230 runs to win, or 229 to tie. In the event, as they had scored exactly 229, the match was declared a tie. Validity of DLS method. Since it would be unfair to predict the outcome of a match from minimal play, there needs to be certain numbers of overs being bowled for DLS method to apply. For 50 over matches decided by DLS, each team must face at least 20 overs for the result to be valid, and for 20-20 games decided by DLS, each side must face at least 5 overs, unless one or both teams are bowled out, or the second team reaches its target in fewer overs. If the conditions prevent a match from reaching this minimum length, it is declared a no result. The DL method was devised because of the outcome of semi-final in the 1992 World Cup between England and South Africa, where the most productive overs method was used. When rain stopped play for 12 minutes, South Africa needed 22 runs from 13 balls, but when play resumed, the revised target left South Africa needing 21 runs from one ball, a reduction of only one run compared to a reduction of two overs, and a virtually impossible target given that the maximum score from one ball is generally 6 runs. The DL method avoids this flaw. In this match, the revised DL target of 236 would have left South Africa needing 4 to tie or 5 to win from the final ball. Before DL method, various methods had been used to resolve rain-affected cricket matches, with the most common being the average run rate method, and later, the most productive overs method. These methods had intrinsic flaws and were easily exploitable. They took no account of wickets lost by the team batting second. The DLS method, on the other hand, also received some criticism and has minor flaws. Some criticize on the grounds that wickets are a much more heavily weighted resource than overs, leading to the suggestion that if teams are chasing large targets and there is the prospect of rain, a winning strategy could be to not lose wickets and score at what would seem to be a losing rate. DLS method also does not account for changes in proportion of the innings for which field restrictions are in place compared to a completed match. That's all from this video. Hope you guys are clear. If you have any queries, please comment and like. I will be happy to answer. Thanks for watching. Share and subscribe the channel for latest videos.